Good morning, children. In yesterday's video, you have seen that we did a recap of what we have done the previous week and a few lines we have seen yesterday. We have understood the first two stanzas of the poem and also learned one of the poetic devices, which is rhyming scheme. Today, we'll just look at the last stanza and then we'll look at the last four lines of the poem. Okay. Want me to repeat what happened in the last few stanzas? Yeah. There was this lazy cricket. Was the cricket actually lazy? The cricket was too happy to enjoy the summer, but he was not ready to work towards his future. So the cricket was always happily singing, dancing and going around enjoying the weather. He was taking complete satisfaction of this summer season. What was he meant to do? He was supposed to save something for his future. Which future? The time when he was supposed to save food for the winter and rainy season. But he did not do that, and suddenly the winter starts, rains come, and he finds that his kitchen cupboard is totally empty. He doesn't have any food left which would help him during that time. So he decides that he will go and meet Ant. The ant which stays away from this cricket's place, he thinks that he'll go there, seek help from ant, and he goes to the ant's house and asks, "Ant, will you give me shelter during this rainy season? And will you also provide me some grain?" See, cricket and ant, they're all very small creatures. They don't eat food like how we eat. So instead of asking food, he says, "Will you give me some grains?" Okay, let us see what this ant tells this cricket. Says the ant to the cricket, "I'm your servant and friend, but we ants never borrow, we ants never lend. But tell me, dear cricket, did you lay nothing by when the weather was warm?" Quoth the cricket, "Not I. My heart was so light that I sang day and night. For all nature looked gay. You sang, sir, you say? Go then," says the ant, "and dance the winter away." So the ant tells to the cricket. When cricket goes to ant's house, the ant tells the cricket that, "Hi cricket, I am your friend and servant, but we ants have a policy." What is the policy that the ant has? He says, "We ants never borrow, we ants never lend." Don't you think the ant is too clever? He could have simply said, "No, I can't help you." But he says, "I'm your friend. I'm very much ready to serve you." But he says that we have some policy. And the policy is, we don't borrow anything. We neither give as loan to someone. "But tell me, dear cricket, did you lay nothing by?" Lay nothing by means no savings. Have you not done any savings at all during the summertime? That's why the ant says, "But tell me, dear cricket, did you lay nothing by when the weather was warm?" So the ant is asking the cricket, when it was summer season, when the weather was warm and when it was not raining, didn't you save anything for these rainy days, for the winter season? Quoth the cricket. Quoth means said. Okay. Quoth the cricket. Who said? The cricket said. The cricket said, "Not I." The cricket says to the ant that, "No, I did not have made any savings for this rainy season. My heart was so light that I sang day and night." The cricket said, "I didn't do anything during the summer days because my heart was very light. My heart has told me that I should be happy. It didn't tell me to work." So the cricket says, "My heart was so light that I sang day and night." Don't we do that, children? We'll have something coming up in a day or two, probably a UT or something. And what do we do? "Oh, tomorrow one more day is there. Today I'll watch TV. I'll play with my friends. Tomorrow evening I'll prepare for the UT. Tomorrow evening what we'll do? Night I'll prepare. Now I'll go and play." That's what we always do, right? Not only you. Even adults have that habit. But we have to make ourselves serious and not postpone our things for future. We never know when a problem can come. Can you relate this to today's problem? did we expect that something like this corona covid will come and make us all suffer like this? Aren't you missing going to school? But there are certain things which is not in our hands. But what is in our control, we need to make sure that we do the things properly. We plan our future properly. So here, as the cricket said, my heart was so light, so I spent the days and night singing. For all nature looked gay. The nature was looking very happy. He means very happy. He said the nature looked so happy, so I also wanted to be happy. You sang, sir. You say, who's saying this? The ant is telling this to the cricket. Ant is asking, so sir, you were singing during the summer time. Means the ant has become angry now. Because the cricket did not do anything during the summer time, now the ant is being asked to help the cricket. Won't the ant get angry? Because he said, yes, I am your friend, I am ready to serve you. But ant feels that he should help the cricket if it was actually a problem that the cricket is facing. Cricket is facing this problem because of its carelessness, negligence. So the ant has become angry now. So you sang, sir, you say. Go then, says the ant, and dance the winter away. The ant is really angry and he tells the cricket that if you spend your summer time singing and dancing, better you go and spend your winter days also singing and dancing. Okay, so now that we have seen this, identify the words which are rhyming to the words in the next line. The first line ends with friend. The second line ends with lend. This one ends with by and rhyming with I. Coming on to the next lines, light and night are rhyming. Gay, say and away are rhyming. Mark this. Try to find out the what is it poetic device called? Find it out. Write the poetic device for which we have taken these rhyming words. I am sending you another video where I am going to discuss this poetic device and then the concluding four lines.